Hello everyone and welcome to Attila Total War. So this is going to be a new campaign and it'll be the first Attila campaign I'll ever be doing, so well, let's try it, shall we? So of all the factions, I've decided that I am going to pick the Caledonians. Why? Because, well, first of all, it seems fun to ruin the Roman Empire, and I think both Roman Empires have been done to death by other people, and this will be a very nice little thing that we can try to do. So we're gonna set the difficulty to hard, and well, let's see where does this land us. We are the Caledonians, one of the many barbarian tribes inhabiting the British Isles, and we are here to find a new place in the world.
The air was filled with smoke and blood. Rome was weak. The tribes grew in strength and number. Their roots went deep, and they felt the earth's blood pounding through the land. But their borders were threatened, for a great storm raged in the east. One by one, the tribes scattered as seeds in the wind. And behold, a red horse, and power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth. The blood of their kin would be avenged. Great hunters, they tempered their blades in Roman blood, and saw their once mighty walls reduced to dust. They made ready for war. The Caledonians are all too familiar with the bitter taste of failure. The great conspiracy, an uprising of free tribes against the Roman invaders, was put down on your territory, ravaging your lands in the process. Now, you are troubled by rumors that the Picts and the Abdanians, your neighbors and brothers in blood, dream of reclaiming the Isles in another Britannic rebellion. You will have no part in it, looking instead across the seas for a new ally. The Saxons, smelling Rome's weakness, hasten towards the east coast of Britannia. They will not rest until they have hounded every last invader from your shores, and by joining them, you too may share in the spoils of victory.
Well, that's rather interesting. Let's see how initially objectives. Search this. Let's just go ahead. Loot or sack 3 different settlements. Maintain 10 units. That's done. Defeat this faction. The Abdanians. Loot or sack Eboracum. So, let's get right to it, shall we?
Warriors all ready for orders.
Celtic Levy or Celtic Brigands, both are exactly top quality troops. Let's see what we can do with our starting money. In fact, let's just look at our diplomatic standpoint for now.
Good and noble friend, what an honor you do us.
This option demands that a faction becomes your puppet or tributary state, taking advantage of your military might in exchange for a percentage of
valiant attempt,
and in the case of puppet states, unlimited military access. However, puppet states may find themselves...
Warriors all ready for orders. Let's see, let's upgrade this to... Pashas.
Thirsty for battle.
Let's merge our armies together to form a singular force.
Warriors all thirsty for battle.
Put some Celtic brigands in this army. You know what?
Getting on our way. Is there nothing else?
Let's start besieging the Western Roman Empire.
Praise be to God. Let us have an end of talk.
We take this settlement for the tribe.
This might be a very dumb early move, but we're still
laying
gonna do it.
Siege to their hovels. Aidan, Kishitan.
Well, let's end the turn. Can assign a provincial governor. Oh yes. Not governors, but can start putting people into places. Then let's adopt him quickly. And let's end the turn. Issue an edict. Then let's wait a turn, we'll start constructing next turn when we actually have... Well, it will become cheaper to do so. Secure into the fort. Alright. Now that construction is cheaper. Build pastures here. And let's begin the first battle of our campaign. Beginning of the end of the Romans, if we execute it right. It's a rather small settlement, so we've got to make sure we do it properly. We have numbers to our advantage, but the Western Roman units will be superior to ours, and we must keep that in mind.
Remember that the goal here is to capture the settlement, not destroy it. To achieve victory, either kill or rout the entire army, or capture the central plaza. Before you begin, ensure that any siege weapons are positioned close enough to target the enemy defenses.
This gate is probably the easiest one to enter. Oh, that's fun.
They will bleed for us.
Indeed.
Ready.
Yo, you have our spears.
Let's put Celtic, the Celtic band on the siege machines, and let's begin. This might be a hard battle if you're not careful. The towers here are broken, which is great.
Fire on them.
We'll try taking out the scout equities because they should be relatively lightly armored. This tower might not make it too far. This tower has made it. Let's start bringing up the rear echelons. Let's engage the Levis Armature. There's a Celtic band. They got massacred where they stood. That was a dumb move on my part. You know, I just keep firing on the scout equities.
Infantry! Kill! 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 Get moving!
Looks like the breakthrough will be made in this part. You know, I'm just going to bring more troops to this side because I don't think that we're going to make any progress here. We finally made a breakthrough here.
We hunger for blood and battle, an evil battle.
No, 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 don't fire. Let's hopefully shatter them here.
The enemy have rallied their units.
And ready. Gotcha. Understood. Infantry.
Let's get these men on the walls. Let's wipe out the rest of their Scourge of God unit. Oh no, these guys get off the walls, please. As it should have.
Missile warriors.
God damn these fools. Let's organize over here.
The general is dead. A lethal blow.
He should have been for quite some time.
They will bleed for us. Deadly missiles ready.
We'll kill them all.
Our warriors, move out. Missile warriors.
Come on, yes, unleash into the battle, doesn't mean that I.
Ready for battle!
Oh no. Come on, break the Limitana here. No, don't rout Warlord. Don't surrender, not now.
Melee warriors!
Warriors! Eager for blood! Aye!
Loose!
Take aim! Kill! Ah!
They will bleed for us! Deadly missiles ready!
We hunger for blood and battle!
Missile warriors! gates! Forward!
Oh, finally we can use our cavalry. Let's handle this properly. We do very high casualties in this battle, but it'll all be worth it, I'm sure. Sextus Brennus.
The enemy settlement burns!
Let's not get ourselves torn to pieces here.
Missile arms, riders! A unit has used all available ammunition. Warriors eager for blood! Kill, kill, kill!
We require a lot of charge damage on the Palatina guards. It's a Pyrrhic victory, but a victory nevertheless. We've lost quite a lot of our Celtic band, which is unfortunate. But we've broken Roman resistance. But at what cost? Lost half our army doing this. Let's sack the settlement. Loot or sack.
Ready for battle. For the tribe. Thirsty for battle.
Let's just loot and occupy, honestly. We shall keep heading up, making our way southwards. This might be bad. We've done that. Heard on the Eblana slowly.
Thirsty for battle.
Make pastures for sure. Let's end the turn.
For the tribe.
Public order, please. And that's the end of turn 2. Favoring loyalty? Who? Him. Well, this could be bad.
Ready for battle.
Let's build a granary. Try to get onto Lindum.
Besieging settlement. To battle.
Let's see, can we take this on? You know what? I think that'll be a good time to end this episode. Hope you guys have enjoyed the first moves of our Caledonian campaign. We've taken our first walled city, but at a very high cost. So, hope you guys have enjoyed that. Leave a like if you liked the video, subscribe if you want to see more, and put anything you want to say in the comments below. So, I'll see you guys next time as we continue our Caledonian campaign. And until then, take care.